Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father God, we thank you, Father God. Yes, indeed, you are an awesome God. We are serving an awesome God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We thank you, Father God, that you are so awesome in our lives, Father God. We thank you, Father God, for your faithfulness to us. We thank you, Father God, for your mercy. We thank you, Father God, hallelujah, for the way you're molding and shaping our lives into the image of the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you for your Holy Spirit that leads us, guides us, directs us, and teaches us the deep things of God. Father God, we pray, hallelujah, in this fellowship tonight, that you will be awesome, you will be magnified, you will be exalted. To you, Father God, we give you all the glory, the honor, the praise, and all the worship, Father God, because it rightfully belongs to you. Father God, we pray, hallelujah, that you will shine your light deep in our hearts, Father God. Plant our portion very deeply in our hearts, so that your word will take root very deeply in our hearts, grow and bear, Lord God, your godly fruit, your kingdom's fruit, hallelujah, your Holy Spirit fruit, hallelujah, in every areas of our lives and also through our lives, Father God, hallelujah, so that others, Father God, hallelujah, may pick it, may pick from it, Father God, and enjoy the goodness of God, hallelujah, coming out from us. We thank you, Lord God. We pray, hallelujah, that you bless your people, Father God, that you are here. We pray, Father God, that you do something great, something new, something awesome in the hearts of your people tonight. We cover this meeting with the precious blood of Jesus. Cover your word with the precious blood of Jesus. Well, Lord God, we pray and we ask you all these things in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And amen. And amen. And amen. Clap offering to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, eh? It's our prayer that God is going to do something new, something great, hallelujah, on the inside of you. Amen. Praise the Lord, eh? Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. We are all welcome this evening. Thank you for braving the weather, braving whatever else that the devil tries to make you stay at home. But you had enough godly tenacity on the inside of you to come anywhere. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Eh? We are continuing with our study on prayer. Hallelujah. Tonight. But before we start, anybody would like to share or testify or encourage us with a word of testimony? Does anybody have anything to share? Hallelujah. But the studies that we've been touching, hallelujah, how God has been revealing himself to you, how you, hallelujah, have been deepened and, hallelujah, enjoying the studies that we've been learning. Praise the Lord. Studies that we've been studying and the hardship that they've been going through, hallelujah, it gives them just an encouragement to push on, to move on, hallelujah, seek God, amen, praise the Lord, And the sabo kami na pati ko na kalori na mundo umbula na bitumani, Brother Joe, Sister Illy, praise the Lord, na wale, praise the Lord, hallelujah, na bibo kalim tayo, bibo kati tungo tayo na kalori na mundo umbula kaya na buwan, praise the Lord. Pastor Harry, would you like to say something?
Yes, this study that we are going through, especially on the Bible study that we are going through, especially on the topic of prayer. Prayer do is something very important, especially in Christian life. But what we have learned in our last lesson, the words that we still touches my mind or still touches me, is about the accuracy that we pray. This binds us or reminds us that what we are asking and how much I can guarantee myself that I will receive.
Amen.
Now, nobody else can guarantee my statement.
Amen.
Because I prayer with God. Now, my statement will rely to me as how much bad I have done, how much good I have done, weighing on that, on the accuracy whether God is going to listen to me. And furthermore, you were saying you got to be specific on that.
Amen.
What you are asking for, you are asking for that.
Amen.
You don't bundle up many things.
Praise the Lord.
Like if you are asking for one particular healing, pray for that particular healing.
Praise the Lord.
And that is also touching me. And then it reminds me about the condition of this later.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
So building these things, it's almost a circle thing, and then prayers are answered.
Amen.
And then if prayer is not my prayer, if maybe your prayers are answered always, if my prayer is not answered, then I have to look at myself, what is my wrong and what is my right.
Praise the Lord.
And then I align myself with God. And that's what is touching me, those three words.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Pastor Harry. Hallelujah. Amen. Eh? So we thank you. Eh? God ministers to each and every one of us differently. Eh? Because we are at various stages of faith and our growth in God. Eh? So Pastor Harry, that touches him. Somebody else, something else will touch them. Eh? So everybody's have a portion or a share from the service. Amen. Eh? Nobody will live the same way they came. Eh? Praise the Lord. Thank you, Pastor Harry. That is so true. That is so true. Praise the Lord. Rest assured that the preacher himself too is also learning. Eh? I'm also learning every time I step up here. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Eh? Thank you very much. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Na kami singin ikuwa bakalo matekem do na kalo. Hallelujah. Na beka handala ko dumatiko na ugani buli anda sa muta tiko ma. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Do talbe tu kunya, do talbe kaita do na ka ba pala na kaita sa muli tiko. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Na wale.
Amen. Amen. We want to be without tangan na kalo na. Umaru to asal nak lu nak bunyi buli itu yang kita mahu cuba lagi jadi malah tu. Obel lah kita nak nak lu berlawan dengan orang di sisi mana. Dan kami kena kuat di itu bila kena angan dan itu yang dibuat. Nah buli itu malah dulu macam pun dah lama ni bila malah kami bila kita pun malah esok itu malah buli. Oba bila awak nak lu na weka kita asing tu di dalam. Mai kita tala ramai ni, wow, contoh tu nunda berbagai ni, berbagai ni lah macam orang pun, balai tadi, berbagai orang tu kan, orang orang tu jumpa masalah apa ni, nak nak kata tu, kau boleh hidup pun lah, facing a challenge. Yo, maru tak, kau boleh bina tala kita nak kelu, macam nanti tu pun ramai ni pun ni beka, itu pun itu beri kita nak awam ni buat. Kita usahle, dah tak cuba, maru tak cuba ni, tu usahre, tu cuma nunggu bincangan. Mereka tu sah, tapi kalau tak sah itu lah, nak kasar kita sah, mai kembali juga nak. Tapi dengan malam sah. Ya, ubin tu dengan aku, aku lagi tengah kira nak keluar. Ubah bila bila tengah kira nak keluar. Nah, kalau begitu mai buli dek itu wasi ni kah? Nah, kita sah mai kah? Nah, mai ubah tak buli dek ini nama itu orang cuci, ubah kita nama bosa, mai buat apa mati ni kau.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Mina kembali ya, weh. Oh, so okay. Thanking Parmeshwar for the great things that the family is learning, and also hallelujah they are beginning to act it out here. Hallelujah, the children and hallelujah the Randini, they're starting to take that step forward. Hallelujah, God is deepening their roots. They're learning so much and enjoying God. Hallelujah, in a fresh way. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Eh? It is the season for it. The timing is right. The season is right. The anointing is right. Hallelujah. You being here is right. Praise the Lord. Eh? And the sin that you call. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God knows what you're going through, and God brought you here so that you can hear the teaching and you can go home and apply it. Eh? In the situation that you're going through. Praise the Lord. Eh? Kau ti kundong sa ngamay na kalu. Kau ti kenda doru sa ngamay. Amen. At sa pagkabili binang sa ngamay, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. That's good. That's good. God is answering the prayers. God is meeting the needs. Eh? Hallelujah. We are, this is because of the request we have from last week, but somehow in my spirit I felt that it is also right that we should touch on it, the lesson that we're about to touch tonight, because it is also part of prayer. Praise the Lord. It is also part of prayer, but somehow it's somehow neglected or misunderstood in prayer or in churches, especially the usage of it. When doana tiki ni masu ka so ngau na enda sinta kila minaka so ngau na kaya kasi ni mga tabu bulitaki sa ayaw do may pagkamit ng dobay na tig ngay balilo. This topic that we're about to be touching, praying in the spirit or speaking in other tongues, depends which congregation you go to, which church is there, different places, but it all talks about the same thing, about praying in tongues. It is a part of prayer, it's a very powerful part of prayer, but somehow, if we don't have the correct understanding of it, it can be abused and misused and also neglected. Praise the Lord. Amen, yeah? Praise the Lord. Let's go to some foundational scriptures before we go deep into it. Eh? Come to Acts chapter 2. Acts chapter 2. Dagdaka waserua from verse 1 to verse 4. We have two scriptural hallelujah, two texts, two scriptural foundation to go to look at. Eh? Acts chapter 2, hallelujah, in some circles this is probably called the outpouring of the Holy Spirit. You've probably heard there's a particular Sunday which we in Christian circles they call Pentecost Sunday. I believe there's also an island in the Solomon Islands that is called Pentecost Island. Yes. Auntie always going like this. Yes. Praise the Lord. We just came from a fellowship tonight. There was two Solomon girls in there. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We won't tell you the uniform. We asked those two girls to bring for Auntie Oli. Praise the Lord. Acts chapter 2 verses 1 to 4. Are you there?
Amen.
Let me read from my Bible. It says like this. When the day of Pentecost had fully come. Pay attention to that word, eh? Had fully come. So it came in the right time, in the right season, eh?
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Yes. Praise the Lord. Yes. Praise the Lord. Yes. Time, the season, the bang, kay sobra na ko. If you read about Jesus' birth, was the same thing. Eh? In Galatians, he says, in the fullness of time, God sent his son.
Yes.
I thought I might just mention it. God works with time and season. God no more season. Praise the Lord. They were all with one accord in one place. Unity is very important. If you want to accomplish anything for God. Amen. Praise the Lord. And suddenly, everybody say suddenly.
Suddenly.
See, God may be slow, but when it is time, he moves suddenly. He may be slow concerning answering your prayer. Suddenly. Praise the Lord. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven, as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. I like Auntie Oli, she always says, this is our sitting. But here it is. Praise the Lord. Then there appeared to them divided tongues of fire, and one set upon each of them. Praise the Lord. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them. As the what?
Spirit.
As the Spirit gave them utterance. Notice it is the Holy Spirit that causes them to speak in other tongues. Not the Jesus. Remember that testimony? Yeah, praise the Lord. Amen. As the Spirit gave them. So it is the Spirit. Eh? I heard Reinhard Bonnke said this in a Hillsong conference that I attended. He said, when God baptized them with the Holy Spirit, each tongue of fire that came upon them had their names on it. It was specifically just for that person. So in other words, Praise the Lord. So when God sends the tongues of fire here, she cannot give it to this one. Because it's specifically meant for her. It is being tailor-made specifically for her temperance, for her personality. Specifically now, she cannot give it to anybody else.
Yes.
And neither can. You understand now?
Amen.
Because it is specifically for you. Tailor-made for you. You cannot give it to anybody else. They have to go to God and God will give it to them. You understand? If it's not clear, say something. If it's not clear, say something. Amen? Why? Because in some churches they think they can. In some churches they think they can. No. If you read carefully, it says here in verse 4. Hallelujah. As the Spirit gave them. So it is the Spirit giving it, not the person. It is the Spirit. Notice it's a Spirit with a capital S. Not a Spirit with a little s. It is the Spirit with a capital S, which is the Holy Spirit. The third party of the Trinity. Nakalosarangabatekwa is sulia yandu dua bekenda na nonda isuli soli membale tikenda saranga. Esini rondo be isuli taka. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. You understand that so far? Come to 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Oh, hallelujah. I don't know how far I'm going to get into this thing, but and the sala ko to mga kinakalo. E safe take. Praise the Lord. Kona kango ko to buru wili kana boni ko ko kana kake to da kada to abita no tati ko sister Salote, pay careful attention. Sister Salon, this is what we were discussing the other day. Kona kato buru lako mo. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Praise the Lord. So na ngona ni to fellowship ni dagati ko na ngunti wala ning dua tanga Bible mata Bible study butan. Praise the Lord. That's why Sister Philo want to hang around. Hallelujah. Nothing worry. 1 Corinthians chapter 12. Okay, we will read it from verse 1 onwards to verse 11. Praise the Lord. Now concerning spiritual gifts, brethren, I do not want you to be ignorant. Brother, don't be ignorant. In other words, you're supposed to study it. You're supposed to learn it. Amen. Sindondon menda yalo wa itaka ti kona kango eh. Kwa mga dono me mata bubul tere ni songo songo leni lo. Amen. This is supposed to be taught in the church. Amen. Praise the Lord. Here we go. Verse 2. You know that you were Gentiles carried away to these damn idols. However, you were led. Excuse me. Therefore, I make known to you that no one speaking by the Spirit of God calls Jesus accursed, and no one can say that Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. Here we go, verse 4. There are diversities of gifts. There are what?
Diversity of gifts.
Diversities, in some translation, it's called variety. What's your translation?
Different.
The matale, any more? Diversity, variety, the matale.
Different.
What else? Okay, so they are different of gifts. So there's different gifts, plural. But the same spirit. Small S or capital S?
Capital
S. Praise the Lord. There are differences of ministries, but the same
Lord.
So you see here different ministries, different ministry focus. Different churches, different ministry focus. Not all churches are the same. Don't think for 1 minute every church is the same.
Yeah.
Different churches, different ministry focus. Because their ministry focus is different. Are those people do it like that? Yeah, because their ministry focus is different.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Eh? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Eh? Different gifts, different calling, but the goal is the same. The goal is to win the lost to Christ.
Yes.
But we may minister to them differently.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because not all the fish are the same. Eh?
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So some fish, eh? They got strong teeth. Eh?
Mm.
They bite the net. Eh? So you need to smack them in the head so that they can calm down a bit. Eh?
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Just saying. Amen. Praise the Lord. Are you catching it?
Yeah.
Where we up to? Verse what? Verse what?
Verse 5.
Okay. There are diversity of gifts, but the same Spirit. There are differences of ministries, but the same Lord. And there are diversity of activities or operations, but it is the same God who works all in all. So you cannot compare each church to another.
Yeah.
You cannot compare each ministry to another.
Yep.
Eh?
Right.
But when there's not looking in a comparison, because it's right here, because it's different. Can I say, before I go forward, I need to say this. Let me put it in a physical sense. Some churches, they're electrician churches. Some churches are mechanic churches. Some churches are carpenter churches. Some churches are plumbing churches. So if you've got a plumbing gift, God will put you in the what?
Plumbing
churches. Eh? But if you go to the electrician church, you'll notice there will be some toilet on top of the roof, eh? You know why? Because you're in the wrong church, in the wrong place, in the wrong time. Now you may start off in the electrician church, then you may go here for training purposes, and then you will end up in the plumbing church. You see? Because you need to learn all of it, eh? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yeah, but you might end up in the plumbing church because that's your gift. Eh? But your gift needs polishing and development, and God will take you through all the process. Eh? Mm-hmm. You understand now?
Amen.
So no more that tosso ikeda tuva ka Italia ni sembera ni tukuna na kalo menda tos. So you're in the wrong place, wrong time, wrong season. Everybody else enjoying themselves in the church and they're praising, worshiping. You standing over there and what's wrong with me? How do I know that? Because I did it myself. You, speaking from experience. I looked around and everybody, yeah, hallelujah, praise the Lord. And I'm standing there. I didn't feel anything. Everybody else getting a touch of God, eh? Except me. I go, oh, I think I'm in the wrong place. I think I better get back to my old church, where I'm supposed to be. So I had to go apologize to the pastor, apologize to God, and apologize. Praise the Lord. So I had to go back. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So be careful, eh? Be careful. Praise the Lord. Amen. So if you're looking for a church, you should be praying, Father God, where am I supposed to be planted so that I can grow and be a fruitful Christian? Eh? Sometimes you go to a place and bang, it hits you straight away. And you'll know it straight away. There'll be an inner witness and you go, yeah, this is where I'm supposed to be. Praise the Lord. Because everything else I did somewhere there, it wasn't as fruitful as, eh? You were putting great effort, but nothing was coming out. Sometimes you'll just go there and say, this is the place. God will confirm it to you. Praise the Lord. And confirm that's a lot of people. Any questions? I know there's a lot of questions here. I've touched her. Brother Messi?
Sorry.
No, that's all right.
Oh. So that is why it is important for a person who coming to church to know the purpose, not the process.
Yeah. Absolutely. Because the process belongs to God, eh?
Yeah. But no one can stuck while you're in a process. So that's the key up the two kids.
Yeah, that's right. That's
right.
Why is that fella there? I should be there. Well, no, you're in the wrong place. Eh? Now we're lusting over. It's called covetousness. Eh? Now you're coveting over a position in the church. Pastor, eh? You should promote me. Pastor, you should promote me. Anna, you should promote me. Eh? And all the time, pastor looking at him and saying, but I don't see any fruit in you, and I haven't got that inner witness to promote you. Because pastor, you praying it, eh? Praise the Lord, eh? Hallelujah, here. We're not gonna put somebody here who's full of the devil. Praise the Lord, eh? Little devil tomorrow, big devil, bigger devil today. Praise the Lord. Would you like somebody to preach to you with a big devil? Praise the Lord, eh?
Hallelujah.
Tiboro mana tingu sa sangay tingu melautan.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Don't worry, Auntie Ole will do it. Praise the Lord. Do talbe taro, that's true. Do talbe taro, do si matatabua. Any questions or anybody want to add something to it? I know, I haven't even touched the thing. This is just the introduction. Anybody want to say something? Do I tingu nidoraka? Do I lava duruma indoraka bango? Yo, Brajo.
Yeah.
Amen, eh? But you wonder how every time I come to Fiji to come and do the mission in Fiji, I have to go to faith, eh? And let Pastor Flory know that I'm here in Fiji and I will be based in Narere Navasai Church. Anna? Eh? Praise the Lord. But maybe next time, Pastor, you better watch out because Sister Oli maybe grab me all over the place, eh? Yeah, so you better put in your application first, otherwise, eh? You're gonna be late and she's gonna marrow, eh? Praise the Lord. Eh? So I have to go, ask. Let her know, praise the Lord, that I'm here in Fiji. I will be ministering in Narere for this time, praise the Lord. Amen. Don't must you go. Hallelujah. Eh? So I will be with Pastor Tish. So I said, she said, okay, that's fine, you can go. So when I have that clearance, then I go, eh? Then I come. Pastor Tish, I'm here, what do you want? Eh? And Pastor Tish, okay, come. Let's kill one buttock, Hana. We come first and then we discuss. Praise the Lord. I'm not saying that so that he will kill the duck, but I'm just saying it. Eh? Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Santoro chigoya, eh? Santoro chigoya, eh? God is a God of order. Okay? Everything in God works by systems and order. There is a proper structure. Did I say the proper? Proper. Did I say the other one? Anyway, there is a proper structure and system that God operates by. Nanu mabin na katsigong wong. One tatala said, when the pattern is right, the glory will fall.
Amen.
When the pattern is right, the glory will fall. Ni daka daka po kabinaga na daka daka ni kalo. The anointing flows.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Eh? This is the reason we're doing teachings like this, so that we know where to stand, how to stand, and what we're standing for. Praise the Lord, eh? Praise the Lord. It's good that we're learning the purpose and also learning the process, eh? So we know it from both sides, amen? Praise the Lord, amen. Hallelujah. Anybody else before we move forward? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Okay, verse 7, come to verse 7, please. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to each one for the profit of all. Atorra chico, ma i soli soli so lingua di veico, e so lingua di veico, ma rauni profitina nei soli soli lo tutto dopo, not just you.
Yeah.
Amen. I think I said it to these ladies here. God gave you the gift there so that the church will benefit. Not that so you can get a name for yourself and start your own ministry. I seem to be seeing this a lot in Fiji. Eh? Somebody got the gift of healing, gift of deliverance, gift, whatever gift they've got. Eh? They go away and start their own ministry. Remember, all the gifts of the Holy Spirit is given to the body so that the body can benefit. That gift, the anointing of that gift will only operate properly under the umbrella of protection of a pastoral leadership.
Yep.
Amen.
Amen. Huh?
Yes.
Praise the Lord. It will only, if you go up here, only for a little while, somehow, mother, the anointing will dry up. You're left on your own. Because it is the anointing that does everything, eh? Not your gift. Your gift is useless without the anointing. Yes.
Now, this is not from the Bible,
huh?
But a thing that came and went away. In Nandi, there was a tree. In Hindi name is Neem, eh? My father, you will tell what it is there. Now, what happened? That tree started to give out some milk substance. Now, from the bottom, it came up, and halfway, we could see a sound, similar nature, and milk substance, white substance, started to flow. That is unusual. It doesn't happen. We have a lot of trees around here, similar. So what happened, the owner of that house, he says, okay, now God is here. They said, the snake God is here.
Right.
Okay. And he's giving that thing. Then he started collecting money. And then says, you're going to build a temple or whatever that nature. While in Nandi, I was a policeman, so I also visited it. And then soon after, a couple of weeks went off. It was normal.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah. So this one, we cannot say where it come from. I cannot say it came up, say it was God or whatever, or anything of that nature. But it came and it vanished. Now, as you are saying that if you are under the pastoral leadership, then there is a sort of protection. And protection and monitoring. And when that is there, then you are on the safe.
Amen.
Safe.
Amen.
And when you are deviating it from there, then you lose that thing.
Yeah.
So whatever in the tree was, as I said, word or whatever, belief that came. And slowly, because the man said, he started making money out of it.
Right.
And the tree went
away. Amen. Praise the Lord, eh?
Yeah.
But see, I'm not quoting any scripture. This is not in the scripture. But this is a true story.
Right.
From a tree
that
came and it went away.
Right. Praise the Lord, eh? Sama tatu juga bikin, dai. Praise the Lord. Angga roni minaka, eh? So be very careful. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah, eh? Yeah? Because all of us have some kind of gifting on the inside of us that God has equipped us with. Now the development of that gift, hallelujah, will depend on which church you belong to, so that your gift can be developed to the point it is bearing fruit, eh?
Like in saying, then we have to judge whether it is from God or it is from some other source of power.
That's right. Yes. That's right. Amen, eh? Maybe we can another look. Thank you, Pastor Harry, eh? That's right.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Amen? Hallelujah. Sama tata chugaya. Okay. Can we go to verse 8? For one is given the word of wisdom and through the Spirit, to another the word of knowledge through the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another gifts of healings. Notice different gifts of healing. The gift is plural and the healing is plural. Eh? Did you notice that in your Bible? It's gifts and healings. Mm. Both are plural.
Yeah.
They're both plural. Eh? Single. You better get the plural Bible, eh? Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Get the plural Bible, eh? Eh, because the gift and the types of healings, God is not restricted to one method of healing. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Eh? Moses met God in a burning bush. Is that right?
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Eh? Because God can speak to you. God doesn't have to speak to you in the burning bush again. Eh? So stop praying for the burning bush experience. Praise the Lord. Oh God. Oh God. Praise the Lord. Okay. Amen. Verse 9. To another faith by the same Spirit, to another gifts of healings by the same Spirit. Verse 10, to another the working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another discerning of spirits, to another different kinds of tongues. Amen.
Amen.
The speaking in tongues is different kinds, eh? They're not all the same. Did you know that?
Yes.
Naka. To another the interpretation of tongues. My speaking in tongues is different to Esther. Philos, speaking in tongues, different to Esther. Get together, well, eh? If we are all baptized in the Holy Spirit when we speak in tongues, all our speaking in tongues will be all different, not all the same. Have you noticed that? Yeah. Eh? Because mine is specially mine. Yours is specially yours. Yours is specially yours. So it'll be different. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So don't expect everybody to speak in tongues to be the same. Eh? It'll be all different. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Amen. But one and the same Spirit works all these things, distributing to each one individually as He wills. As the Holy Spirit wills. Eh? Quango, brother. Don't chase after and don't covet the gift of another person.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. You see somebody, eh? You see, let's say a lady comes here and speaks. Eh? Oh, man. Listen. Yeah, I see this all the time, eh? Being a pastor. But, you know, we love the fruit that is coming off people's lives, eh? But what we don't understand, eh, the school of the Holy Spirit they have to go through to be producing that kind of fruit. Amen. You won't even handle the stuff that she goes through. Eh? Hallelujah. But we all love the fruit, eh? But we don't want to go through the process, eh? That is causing the fruit to be bearing there.
Amen.
Eh? Don't want to have fruit. But na kena kata kina fruit menga may buot yung na fruit ya. Menya dua talabi ko sa kibo ya. Praise the Lord. That's a different kind of story. Eh? Because that fruit is not bearing, eh? Just by chance. Eh? It's bearing because of the amount of work that has gone into it.
Amen.
And some of us, we can't handle the work. Eh?
Praise
God. So be careful. Just enjoy the process that God is taking you through in your development stages. Amen.
Amen.
A development process. Praise the Lord. image, cooperate with God in the process of your growth. Then to somebody say cooperation, Sabina Katibandim.
Cooperation
is very much needed in the church today. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That will mean you have to support the pastor. You have to support the pastor. You have to pray for the pastor.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Right.
When the pastor say, can the church come, and we come and pray here Friday night, my God. Everybody should be saying, hallelujah, pastor. We're going to be here for you.
Yeah.
Yeah? And not only the pastor, the lady come here and nobody else. Praise the Lord. That's the development. Because you have, somewhere along the line, you have to pass the faithful test. Faithful in the little, faithful in the much. If you cannot be proven to be faithful in the little, how are you going to be faithful in the much? When God gives you a ministry of your own.
Yeah.
Amen.
Huh? When God gives you a ministry of your own, how are you going to be faithful serving God in that kind of, praise the Lord, ministry? And God says, okay, you got to travel now, you got to go there now, you got to preach there. How are you going to do that when you haven't even learned faithfulness?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I've hardly touched the thing on there. Praise the Lord. Time is almost up. Amen.
Hallelujah.
That was only the introduction. You don't have to pay for that. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Any questions? Do you have a time? Anybody want to contribute something?
Yes, Pastor.
Uh-huh.
Just concerning gifts.
Yep.
Just only, I'd love to encourage each one of us. Don't come for the gifts. We change churches just because of the gifts. We were only having speaking times over there, prophecy over there. We run. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
As Pastor said, you do not know the process you have to go through. Then to get to there.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So hold on. Amen. Hold on to what God has for you.
Work,
let us work ourselves out for it. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Stop. We've gone through so much of that. We've seen so many. They run here. They say, oh, the children, they are doing this, doing that. They run. But after all, it dies out. Praise the Lord, just only for that certain time. As an example, which Pastor here shared, we must be aware of that. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. God is good.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Can I just add something? She said she's touched on a very special point. Because we see this a lot and we hear it a lot. Being involved in ministry. You understand something in spiritual gifts. What God is doing in the process of your training and development, He's also developing the character. Your character. Because this gift is supported by character.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, Yes.
You will abuse your gift. On a pagayang atagalan mo mo gift, may lauring akin o iko. Mo labiting akin o iko. You won't care about God or God's people. You know, everything that you do will be about you. Because you haven't, the proper character hasn't been developed in you so that, that you understand that this gift is because for the building up of the church of God. It's not about the person that God is using. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
It's for the edifying, it's for the building up, it's for the encouraging, building up of the children of God in the church. It's not about the person that's got the gift. And many pastors, many leaders in the church have fallen on the wayside because they haven't got the proper development of their gift. They've been given the position in the church.
Yeah.
And now they think they're somebody special because now they're up here looking down.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
That's right.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Now they think they're somebody special. And then all the praises of the people gets to their head, and they think, I can do anything I want. Mm-hmm. And then sooner or later, we hear them. They're out there.
Mm-hmm.
What happened to that brother? What happened to that sister?
Yeah.
That's the reason why. Because they haven't, the proper character on the inside of them hasn't been properly developed to support the gift. The character compensates for the gift. And that's how the anointing flows in. Because up here, you can't do anything you want to it. You are very careful, very cautious of what you say up here. Praise the Lord. Kaya kasi develop tayo na ano ng character. Na nung itogo, nung ibaharaw, nung isusun, na katotoo kaya, nung ibosa-bosa, nung kaya kung may naging mo, praise the Lord, it gets to your head, and then you think you're somebody, and then you think you can abuse and misuse anything that is of the church, eh? And you get into trouble. Praise the Lord. Have you experienced that in the church?
Yeah.
Have you seen that in the church?
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Dosa to rotin mo, eh? Praise the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Eh? So you've been trained. Oh, quite kind of kid, eh? I'm going to say you. I said me. Eh? Us. Eh? We've been trained. We've been taught, and we've also been warned. Eh? Meta to ngangaro ni kina. Meta to yangrabo. Meta to kinda. Right? Praise the Lord. Eh? Be careful. Be cautious. Amen. Thank you, Auntie Oli. Praise the Lord. Can we go to our notes? Finally. Praise the Lord. I only got 15 minutes. That's all right. That was the introduction. You happy with the introduction?
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Gift of tongues. Can we read 2-3?
The Holy Spirit given ability to speak in languages not known by the speaker. Or in a language not normally understood by the speaker of the hearers.
Praise the Lord. Now this happened in the book of Acts. We've read the first part of it, eh? If you read further down, you notice when the Holy Spirit was being poured out, there were different people in Jerusalem at that time, from different nations, they came at that time, and when the disciples were filled with the Holy Spirit, they start speaking in other tongues, natural tongues, not Holy Spirit tongues, natural tongues. Erabosa and andu ibosa bosa na non rabosa where na lago may na people no attending God. That's how they know it. Say, hey, these people, how can they know my language? Eh? Praise the Lord. There was a story somebody testified. I'm not sure where. I think he was the only Fijian guy in this church meeting.
Pastor Joe.
And somebody prophesied in Fijian. Prophesied in Fijian. None of those people understood Fijian or speak Fijian. But the Fijian guy that was in that meeting, he understood very well what was being spoken. And the person who was prophesying never been to Fiji, never even spoke Fijian. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So it took God, eh? Sato rana kalu meta kamana kaya. Ini dia, eh? Dua esa sota rana dona kena tukunya. Pa antio? Pas de jolo beno. Right.
Korean.
Okay. Ha bolo. Tukunya tak man? Tak no tak. No.
That's the one you see is not mine.
Iyo.
Well,
just very brief.
Yeah,
he was in a meeting and what happened?
You roared like a lion and then a Fijian word came.
Right. Praise the Lord. Roared like a lion.
Yeah.
Wow.
Lion of Judah.
Okay. Praise the Lord. Ina kanti yoli.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Yeah? So you see, eh? Praise the Lord. So this is what it's saying over here. Praise the Lord. Eh? Praise the Lord. And that was all the time. I didn't learn to be matanga speaking in other tongues. Eh? But that's also speaking in other tongues. You can speak in other tongues under the unction or the anointing of the Holy Spirit in the natural language. Praise the Lord. Can I say this before? I know I'm spoiling it. Eh? But I'll just say it here. You notice in a church service or some kind of a church meeting that we're having, when somebody begins to prophesy in tongues, in Holy Spirit language. Praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. Eh? That is different to somebody just speaking tongues, personal tongues. That's what you got. Personal tongues, get you gonna prophecy tongues. Yeah, there's personal tongues, there's prophecy tongues. Yeah, in the church meeting, where they prophesy in tongues, so it needed somebody to interpret. Yeah? So let's say somebody spoke in other tongues, prophesied in tongues for 10 minutes, praise the Lord, and the interpretation was only 3 minutes. I don't know. The interpretation doesn't have to be 10 minutes also. Why? It's interpretation, not translation. If the prophecy in tongues is 10 minutes, the interpretation can be only 5 minutes or 3 minutes. Because it is interpretation, not translation. Translation is word for word. Yeah? If it's translation, then the translation also has to last 10 minutes. But you notice the gift is interpretation, not translation.
Amen.
Understand now. Praise the Lord. So, kakunya to wow. Okay, I prophesy for 10 minutes. Eh, nakere ba ande? Ange tolunga na minutes. Yeah, because it's interpretation, not translation.
Amen.
Satoru chiko. How many you been in a meeting like that? You've been in a meeting like that where the prophecy came out for a last bell. He just kept on going and going and going. Then when the interpretation comes, maybe only 2 words. Yeah? Repent, for I am the Lord your God. Some of that. And you go, what? All that and interpretation, what I'm going up? Yeah, because it's interpretation, not translation. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Any questions? Dobeta? Dobe tu ndoraka? Anybody want to add on? Yes. Amen. You seem to be shocked at the moment. Praise the Lord. Sa se da sita ana setiko. Praise the Lord. Iyo. Sandi. Taro. Question. Demesi.
Can the gift operate outside what you live?
Define what you learn. What do you mean?
From what you learn right now.
Yeah.
And then the gift can operate outside what you learn.
Oh, absolutely.
Because sometimes we live with God in just what we learn, but God wants to show you more.
Yeah, absolutely. Because you can't limit God. You can't put God in a box. Eh? Yeah. Yeah, you can't put God in a box. God is much more than that. Eh?
Yeah.
God is much more than what you know or will ever experience. Eh? And this is where the Bible tells us, eh? Do not rely on your experience. Eh? Trust in the Lord and lean not unto your what? Yeah, that's why. Sometimes, this is the reason why I say, sometimes God will tell you something you have no frame of reference to lean on. Eh? You just have to obey that word by blind faith. That's it. Eh? You'll just have to step on the water and start walking.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Yeah, you'll have to tell God, I sink or swim. But you better help me. I'm just obeying your word here. Yeah. Because I trust you. And you just go forward. Eh?
Amen.
Sometimes it's like that. The walk of faith is like that. Yeah. Yeah. From your past experience that God has showed you or you've learned. And there's nothing there to rely on. And that's what faith is.
Amen.
Eh? You shouldn't be relying on your past experience. Eh?
Yeah.
Because the Bible tells us not to.
Yes.
Sometimes God will say you and it's totally brand new. Because God is taking you into a new place.
Mm.
New place. New place. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah. New place where you haven't been there before. How can you rely on your own experiences? Eh?
Yeah.
You just have to rely, learn, and trust God. Eh? That it is God speaking to you. You will just have to obey God by faith. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Sometimes God challenges me in the area of giving. Eh? In the area of giving. I thought my giving was all right until God started challenging me. Sometimes I only have the last $10 in my pocket and God will say, give it. I'm saying, man, how am I going to get home? He said, God, give it. I said, God, how am I going to get home? He said, give it. Here. You'll have to trust God. Eh? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen? One day we were missioning in Sawani. Praise the Lord. And the last bus, we were in the house when we saw the last bus go. Wow! Okay, six pass, how long last pass? Then we had to walk. Paidar makira, paidar. No taxi, paidar. Na paidar. And then look, one taxi coming. Hey, stop. Stop. How I will drop us at the pausa there in Sawani. Hey, how much is this? Yeah, no. I'm just going home. Na matumula to go to sleep. Oh, you know what? We got off. We said to the police goodbye because they were at the checkpoint. Walk up. Another van come. Stop. We got off at forestry. Oh, how much is this? No, no, that's all right. This is government vehicle. It's okay, you can just go. So we got off. Go again a little bit further. We stop. One taxi coming. He said, boss, you're my first customer. So take us to Wailu. Praise the Lord. I said to Auntie, man, if God didn't provide the transport tonight, we're still walking now. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. So you can see the provision of God. Eh? Praise the Lord. We should have in a clue. You just have to simply trust God. You will have to simply trust God. And God is going to create new circumstances so that you can trust Him. Eh? He will create new circumstances. Man. Oh, praise the Lord. Eh? Yeah. God will never run out of circumstances. Your faith is going to be tested every step of the way. Eh? Praise the Lord. Pastor Harry.
You know. Once you start to move, then God starts to see you and help you.
Yeah.
If you are continuing thinking and sitting down, you will remain sitting down.
Yeah.
Poverty will come to you, then you will go under poverty because you are only sitting down and thinking. The moment you start thinking, then you see.
Praise the Lord, eh? Hallelujah. Prayers must have legs, one pastor said.
Hallelujah.
Your prayers must have legs.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Eh? If it's okay for the pastor, it should be okay too for the sheep. Eh? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. My time is almost up. In an appearance, 2-3.
In an appearance, his disciples after his resurrection, Jesus declared, and his signs will follow those who believe. In my name, they will cast out demons. They will speak with new tongues. Mark 16:17. Later on the day of Pentecost, the followers of Christ were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues, and the Spirit gave them their utterance.
Okay, the people.
People,
2-3.
The people assembled in Jerusalem for the seized hearing of the very strong promises, with gathered in a variety of languages. They were astonished to hear the speaking of God's word in their own languages. Some had suggested that the miracle was in the hearing rather than speaking, but his explanation transfers the miracle from the believing disciples, as they were to Jesus' promise would be departed to the mother of God.
Clearly,
the miracle was as
praise the Lord. Amen, eh? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. The speaking with other tongues. Eh? The speaking with other tongues. We will dig deeper into it. Eh? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Eh? Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And do you have any experience in speaking in other tongues? Anybody want to share their experience in speaking with other tongues? How did you receive it? How did you get it? What did you do with it? How many here you can speak with other tongues? Lift your hand. Praise the Lord. Okay. Praise the Lord. That's good. Amen. Inaka, you notice there is an added arsenal to your weapon, eh? And no masuni masuni be no tani. Praise the Lord. Eh? When you pray in other tongues, the devil cannot understand you. Praise the Lord. It is your secret. We call it. It is your hotline to God.
Amen.
Yeah, you know that song, eh? Call up, call me, call up, I don't know. They may see you there. Praise the Lord, eh? Hallelujah. Okay? Hallelujah. Naseria, praise the Lord, eh? Call him up, eh? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'll say that we're going to serenade Burl Ives. Praise the Lord, eh? Hallelujah. Central never busy. How many remember that song?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Always on the line. Mm-hmm. Sister Anna is looking at me. Naseria, I'm very proud. Never mind, brother Mano, na kailang atabeko. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. Eh? Central never busy, always on the line. Amen. Hallelujah. It is your hotline to God. Amen. Direct. Eh? You don't have to go through the exchange. And by the way, God hasn't got an exchange here where they say, sorry, he's busy right now. Can you wait for half an hour? Mm-hmm. Eh? There's no angel manning. Eh? Hallelujah. The exchange in heaven. Eh? Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. Direct. Yeah? Bang, bang.
Hallelujah.
Spirit to spirit.
Mm-hmm.
Heart to heart. Eh? Engagement. Eh? Praise the Lord. Bang, bang. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Eh? We will get deeper into it. There's extra pages in there so you can go home, read it, apply it. There's explanation there. There's plenty of pages in there. Praise the Lord. Eh? Happy reading to you. Praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. So enjoy it. Eh? Praise the Lord. We will be touching on it. I don't know, but we'll go through it and see how far we get. Praise the Lord. So we didn't go very far tonight. Eh? Praise the Lord. Dove taro? Any questions? Anybody want to add something? Praise the Lord. I can just sense it now. Praise the Lord. Eh? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. My time is up. Eh? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Can we bow our heads in prayer? Hallelujah. Heavenly Father God, we thank you, Father God, for what we have learned tonight. We thank you for our deposits. We thank you for clarifying to us your word and this special gift that you have equipped your church and your people with. Hallelujah. Speaking with other tongues. Thank you, Father God, for baptizing your church, your people, Father God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Are there any people who don't know you want to receive the gift? Anybody here want to receive baptism in the Holy Spirit? You want to pray in this prayer language? Stand up. Stand up. Come up in the front here. Praise the Lord. I'm going to pray for you guys. Hallelujah. If you want to receive baptism in the Holy Spirit, praise the Lord. Amen. It's not good just letting about it and going to receive it. Eh? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I am not the one giving it to you. It is God giving it to you. It is Parmeshwar giving it to you. Hallelujah. Not the pastor, not the church. We've seen it from his word. That it is the Holy Spirit himself giving the gift. Hallelujah. It is God himself doing it. Hallelujah. 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 Just repeat after me. Dear God in heaven.
Dear God in heaven.
I am your child.
I am your child.
Bought by the blood of Jesus.
Bought by the blood of Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Fill me.
Fill me.
Baptize me.
Baptize me.
With your Holy Spirit.
With your Holy Spirit.
And fire.
And fire.
With the evidence.
With the evidence.
Of speaking with other tongues.
Of speaking with other tongues.
Right now.
Right now.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
I pray. This prayer.
This prayer.
And receive the gift.
And receive the gift.
Of your Holy Spirit.
Of your Holy Spirit.
Right now.
Right now.
And thank you.
And thank you.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Speak it out. Begin to worship God and thank God. Hallelujah. Say it out loud. Hallelujah. Thank you, God, for baptizing your children afresh with your Holy Spirit and fire. With the evidence of speaking in other tongues. Hallelujah. Let the fire fall on your children. Hallelujah. Each and every one of them. You see the desires of their hearts. Lord God, hallelujah. You said, Lord God, hallelujah, hallelujah, that you will, hallelujah, you won't withhold your Holy Spirit from us. So give it to them, Father God, according to your word. Hallelujah. Fill them up with your Holy Spirit to overflowing in their life, Lord God. Give them the spiritual language tailor-made to each one of them. In Jesus' name, Lord God. Hallelujah. Yes, Jesus. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. 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 Nakamalem chisum. Hallelujah. Kurangan ikimani balo, mikimani balo, sukanan umni balik. na kabin boy ni sila na nai. Kaya masuta na bin bilaki na bin rasa swar kalo. Tumbedi kimbang ay lo mene alo tabo na kalo. Yung tagi kimbang ay na bin sila kaya na. May kakuwasa rin yung mundo. Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you so much. You are released. If you want to remain in the front, do so. Praise the Lord. God bless you. God bless you.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Pastor Harry, would you like to say a few words? One of the people of God are taking their seats.
Okay, one more time. I would like to express the most appreciation and thanks to Pastor Bose for his ministry and giving us this wonderful teaching on prayer, and in particularly the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, when we speak, it is a gift, and then gift is given to certain people only, and what Pastor has said. But once again, we are honored to receive this. We are thankful that we are able to understand how or what are the processes that we can reach out in order to get this Holy Spirit. As we say, don't rush yourself. Don't imitate. Don't make false things by hearing other people then you want to do the same thing. Let it come to you. And when God gives you, that is a special gift to you. You know, we hear, and we can meditate on that. What Pastor has said, we will try to do the same. But I think that is not true. But if you are covered with the Holy Spirit, when you receive the power, a special language will come to you. And maybe somebody will be able to translate what he says. I myself, I am also struggling. I try to get those words. I try to copy some people. But again, I say, no, copying is not good. I cannot copy. Let it come to me. And let that be an original to you. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And now, once you are connecting yourself to God, it will come. When the disciples connected themselves with God, they remained, they were patient, they were humble, and only this. And then it came on time. And you will not be surprised. It will come suddenly, as the scripture says.
Yes,
suddenly it will strike. And then you will rejoice in that spirit. Praise the Lord. So let's give one clap offering to our Father.